Habló con la joven que fue atacada con ácido. La atacó con ácido.
Colombia is the country with the highest number of acid attacks against women, a reality that was invisible until March 27, 2014, when a video of Natalia Ponce being attacked was broadcasted in all news channels. But she refused to become a victim. She became a fighter for victims' rights, recognizable by the mask she wore, convincing Congress to pass a law that gives 50-year sentences against aggressors. But the attacks continued and the aggressors were not being pursued. Now, she had to rally an entire country to make her fight their fight, pressuring government to commit to this law and health institutions to provide for the right care.
Bueno, hola, soy Natalia Ponce de León. Fui atacada el 27 de marzo del 2014 en la casa de mi madre.
Cuando me llevaron al centro médico, lo que hicieron fue darme un acetaminofén y esperar 5 horas para que me hicieran algún tratamiento.
Tuve 3 meses en el centro de salud y cuando miraron que me estaba infectando y todo, me trasladaron a Pasto.
Me han hecho 25 cirugías y aún faltan más para terminar el tratamiento.
De los 4 años que le dieron de cárcel, solo pagó un mes porque le pagó 24 millones a la juez y ya.
Yo exijo que nos enseñen a actuar adecuadamente frente a un ataque con ácido.
Yo exijo más y mejores unidades de atención a quemados en Colombia.
Yo exijo la aplicación de la ley a los agresores.
Yo exijo que las entidades de salud no sean otro agresor de las víctimas.
Natalia Ponce, hoy apareció sin máscara.
In a massive press conference, Natalia took off her mask for the first time, handing it to the press, asking them to wear it so no other Colombian would. And the press did just that, kicking off a massive PR movement. The movement grew through a cross-media campaign, getting a flood of free press from social and traditional media, bringing the issue to light, motivating individuals, groups, and businesses to participate by wearing a mask through the website or an app. A direct mail was sent to government officials and healthcare leaders inviting them to put on the mask and to commit to Natalia's cause. And one by one, they did. From the First Lady to mayors, congressmen, district attorneys, and doctors, the story of Natalia has changed things. The police is committed to create specialized squads to pursue acid attackers. Hospitals are committed to train their staff in acid attack care. Government is regulating acid sales just like gun sale is. Colombians wore a mask so no other Colombian woman would ever have to again.